Now let us discuss the chapter Introduction to Graphs. Have you ever seen the graphs in newspaper, textbook, magazine somewhere? So what is the purpose of the graphs? So the purpose of the graphs is to show the numerical facts in the visual form so that we can understand easily, quickly and clearly. So actually the graphs are the visual representations of the numerical facts, but the data can be represented in the form of a table. But however, the graphs means the graphical representation of any data we can understand easily. And even if you want to compare a trend or any comparison, if you want to make any comparison, so the graphs are very helpful to us so that we can understand easily. There are different types of graphs, means there are different types of graphical representation. So the first one we can take that bar graph, or sometime we draw the double bar graph. And we can take circle graph, or this is also known as pie graph. And next one, histogram. Next one is line graph. And the last one is linear graph. So there are the different types of graphs: bar graph, circle graph, or also known as pie graph, histogram, line graph and linear graph. Now let us revise all these types of graphs. So the first one, bar graph. So what is a bar graph? So a bar graph shows the comparison among the different categories, and a bar graph consists of two or more vertical or horizontal rectangles. So if you take the example, in this example, on the horizontal line the term exams are taken, and on the vertical line the marks in mathematics of a student are taken. So in the first term he has got 30 marks in the mathematics, so representing the first term maths marks, so there is a one rectangle, vertical rectangle. And in the second term he got 40 marks. So to represent the 40 marks in the second term exam in mathematics, so there is another rectangle to show 40 marks. And in the third term exam he got 50 marks. So to show the 50 marks in third term examination in mathematics, so there is another rectangle. So here these three are the vertical rectangles to show the first term, second term, third term examinations. Now we can compare whether the marks of the student are increasing or decreasing. We can easily say that the marks of the student in mathematics are increasing. So when you compare from first term to second term or second term to third term. Now if you want to show the comparison between two Have you ever seen the graphs in relation to graphs? Have you heard the chapter introduction? Now let us discuss of any data is the graphical representation. Graphs mean what? The form of a table, but however be represented in the form, but the data can of the numerical facts. Representations of graphs are the visual, the so actually easily, quickly and clear, so that we can understand in visual form. Numerical facts in the is to show the, so the purpose of the graphs of the graphs. So what is the purpose? Magazine somewhere, newspaper, textbook. there are different types of graphs. So there are linear graph, and the last one is next one is line graph, histogram, and next one pie graph, or this is also known as circle graph, and we can take graph, double bar, or sometime we draw the graph, we can take that bar. So the first one we types of graphical representation. Graphs means there are different types of, there are different easily, so that we can understand, helpful to us, very helpful to us comparison. So the graphs are reason if you want to make any comparison or any compare, if you want to compare actually, and even we can understand easily. Marks he got, and in the second vertical rectangle there is a one rectangle term maths marks, so the representing the first mathematics, so in the math 30 marks in the first term he has got are taken. So in mathematics of a student, vertical line the marks in terms are taken, and in the term exactly line on the horizontal example, in this example. So if you take the horizontal rectangles, vertical are two or more consist of, and a bar graph and categories. Comparison among the different shows the compare. So a bar graph graph. So what is a bar graph? Which one bar graph graphs? So the first all these types of graphs revise linear graph. Now line graph and pie graph, histogram, circle graph are also known as bar graph. Circles the chapter introduction to graphs. Have you ever seen the graphs in your comparison between two sub? Now if you want to show the second term to third term, first term to second term, as you compare from first are increasing, so when of the student in mathematics say that the marks we can easily increasing or decreasing, marks of the student are in compare whether the, now we can come examinations first term, second term, third terms to show the three are the vertical rectangle. So here these rectangle mathematics, so there is another examination in mathematics 50 marks in third term. So to show the 50 marks third term exam he got, and in the newspaper, textbook, magazine somewhere. So what is the purpose of the graphs? So the purpose of the graphs is to show the numerical facts in the visual form, so that we can understand easily, quickly and clearly. So actually the graphs are the visual representations of the numerical facts, but the data can be represented in the form of a table. But however the graphs means the graphical representation of any data. Now let us discuss there are different types of graphs, means there are different types of graphical representation. So the first one we can take that bar graph, or sometime we draw the double bar graph. And we can take circle graph, or this is also known as pie graph. And next one, histogram. Next one is line graph. And the last one is linear graph. So there are the different types of graphs.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.